We all use energy in every aspect of our lives. We use it to produce electricity, provide warmth, grow food, even to make the clothes we wear. In recent times, we've been searching for an energy source that's capable of satisfying three key criteria. It's got to be clean, reliable, and abundant. There's only one source capable of satisfying all three: fusion. Fusion is a nuclear reaction that releases a vast amount of energy. It's the process that powers our sun. For all the complicated science and technology that surrounds it, at its heart, it's simply the process of burning fuel to release energy. And like any fuel-based resource, for example, coal or wood, all we're trying to do is heat it to the point of ignition, the point at which we no longer need to add more heat, we only need to add more fuel. For fusion on Earth, this point is achieved at 100 million degrees. That's 10 times hotter than the core of the sun. So how do we reach such high temperatures? Well, there's a few different ways to do it, but my research involves using the world's most powerful lasers together. These lasers are massive, and they typically operate at about 100 billion times the power of your microwave. The largest facility on Earth, the National Ignition Facility, aims 192 beams onto the inner surface of a small gold can, about the size of a pea. That can rapidly heats up and essentially begins to act like an oven. If you place a capsule of fusion fuel inside that oven, it compresses in 20 billionths of a second. And if we produce enough heat, the capsule compresses fast enough, it undergoes ignition and releases a huge amount of energy, energy we can use to make electricity. We've been studying this technique for decades, and we've not yet been able to achieve ignition. The problems arise as the fuel acts like a fluid when we compress it. It flexes and it mixes and it changes shape. Trying to compress it is like trying to squeeze jelly between your fingers. My thesis proposes some modifications to this technique that we hope can address these problems and take us closer to ignition. The main tool of my research are computer simulations called radiation hydrodynamics codes. Radiation, from the word radiate, meaning produce heat. Hydro, another word for fluid or liquid. And dynamics, another word for movement. Putting those words back together, a radiation hydrodynamics code has to be able to model the heat, how it's produced and how it transports through the fuel, and also needs to be able to model how the fuel moves when it's compressed. On top of this, these codes need to be able to model the absorption of the laser and the various nuclear processes that go on inside the fuel. In these simulations, I can change the materials we use and the timings and the powers of the lasers. In this way, I can design experiments that we can then take and test on facilities all over the world. My work is a contribution to work of hundreds of scientists all over the globe who aim to demonstrate the possibility to use energy through laser-driven fusion. And if we're successful, provide the world with the ultimate energy source.